In CSS, every element can be considered as a box, so that around every element we have some kind of a container or a box. So this box consists of the content, the padding, and the border. Around that box is a margin. So if you look at the illustration, we see the content enclosed in a white box. That would be our content, such as a text or an image. Now, between that content and the edge of the box, which is represented by the green border, we could also apply padding. So padding is the inside roominess of this box or container. By default, our elements do not have borders, but if we wanted to, we could create a border which would enclose the edge or the outer dimensions of that box. And this is represented in the green area. On the top, bottom, right, and left, we have margins. So every HTML element is separated from what's on top of it by a margin. And these margins vary based on the nature of that element. Paragraphs and headings have wider margins than does a div, a section, a header, or a footer. One thing I would like to point out, when you set the width or height of an element using CSS, you are setting the width and height of that content area. I would like to note that it is very unusual to need to set the height. Generally, we are concerned with setting widths. However, the width has to do with the width of the content. Should we add padding or a border, that would actually increase the width of that element according to basic CSS rules. The margins do not affect the width. If we saw these properties being applied to this div, we see that it has a width of 320 pixels, a padding of 10 pixels, and a border of 5 pixels. That border is 5 pixels thickness on each side. That padding is 10 pixels on each side, including the right and left. So if we were to do a calculation, we would see that our width is actually 320 plus 10 times 2, 10 pixels of padding on each side, plus 5 times 2, 5 pixels of border on each side, which actually equals 350. So if you were doing page layout and you were putting containers inside another container, you would need to calculate 350 rather than 320, and this can be an annoyance after a while. CSS 3 has introduced a box sizing property, and by setting the box sizing property to border box, it allows us to add padding and borders to our element. They would be included in the width, not added to it. So we can perform our calculations as we normally would do, with our width being 320. Let's take a look at some very nice layouts that utilize margins and borders and padding. I'm looking at a college website, and here we see four different areas very nicely laid out. Notice how easy it is to read, and these content draws the attention to your eye because it is nicely spaced. On the top of each of these containers, those colored lines are actually a top margin being set at a thicker pixel width and with a different color. On the bottom of each of these containers, we actually see another border. It is a bottom border of a default size and coloration. Notice that there is padding in each one of these containers, which allows for its roominess. Also notice that there is a margin set underneath these containers to nicely separate it from the container underneath it. So here we see the box model properties in action. Another common use of the box model is to enclose the entire web content with a border. So if you look to the right and the left, you can not only see a border, but you can also see the box shadow, which is applied to the border. So this whole web page is enclosed with an outer border to give it a little bit more of a form. On this web page, in the right-hand column, there is this line on the left. Again, that is a border, a left border. and it is visually used to indicate that these are two separate columns, therefore the information inside these columns are in some way related. As I scroll down on my right, the upcoming events, again enclosed in a border. Notice there is some inside padding so that the content is not flush to the left. So this is our box model. And by understanding the margin, border, and padding, you can develop very nice page layouts.